a very good evening. I hope everyone is fine and safe and they are all at home. So today my topic of discussion is mental health education. How mental health education plays an important role in the teacher training course. The mental health education is an important paper that is included in the M.Ed second year syllabus of the Gauhati University. Now, coming back to the syllabus, it's very important for us to know the subject, the objectives that is already there in the syllabus behind the preparation of the subject mental health education. Now, when we're talking about objectives, let us see two or three objectives why mental health education is considered to be an important subject. Firstly, it will give us knowledge about what is mental health. Secondly, what is mental hygiene. Thirdly, it will also deal with the concept of the life skills education and also about the adjustment problems or the maladjustment problems of the adolescents, the students, and also sometimes about the teachers. Or we will also know about the factors that are dealing with the mental health of the students and the mental health of the teachers. So these are some objectives which is already there in the syllabus. And when we're talking about mental health education, it is not that it is only a requirement of a teacher training course, but nowadays even schools and colleges are also dealing and are giving equal importance to this subject, because along with the physical health, it is very important that we should also take care of our mental health. Both physical and mental health plays a vital role in shaping our life, and and it also helps in the enhancement of our personality too. Now, when we're talking about mental health, let us see how mental health as a subject came into existence. Mental health was always there. If we look at the scriptures, or if we are looking about the mental health, how did it come and the evolution of it, we will see that it was always there. The diseases were always there. Maybe as a subject, it was not so much into prevalent or not so much into focus. But now, in due course of time, mental health education is a very important subject that is included in the teacher training courses. And people are giving the utmost attention to this subject. Now, when we are talking about mental health, it is very important for us to know the definitions of mental health. What does mental health actually means? In very simple language, we can say that mental health means the psychological maturity of a person. So, psychological maturity means the person should have a positive attitude towards others and also a very positive and a good attitude towards himself. So, in that sense, we can say that mentally a healthy person is someone, you know, who is always positive in his life, who has a very good insight for life. So, these are some characteristics of a mentally healthy person. Or you can see some definitions of mentally healthy person. The exact definitions is there available in the book. This is just a small example of a mentally healthy person, a small example in the sense. Now, when you're talking about the conditions of the good mental health, we have to look about the behavior patterns. There are some specific behavior patterns, like for example, a person needs to have a sense of responsibility. Okay, he should be a person who is responsible enough for himself as well as for the others. Secondly, he should be a person who is not only responsible, but he should have a sense of individuality. He should possess some personal values. Okay, personal values in the sense a person who has got a philosophy of his life, a good belief, or a person who is imbibed with so many values. So these are some characteristics, not characteristics, but some behavior patterns if I'm talking about. Apart from that, there are some criteria of a good mentally healthy person, some criteria of how we will know that, okay, that this person is mentally healthy. I will just give you two or three criteria. Firstly, a person needs to have a good physical health. Okay, because we know that a sound mind, okay, always resides in a sound body. So firstly, he should have a person with a good physical health. Secondly, he should be confident. Confidence is very important. Thirdly, personal values. Personal values will imbibe all those his values, his worth, imbibed into one person, those things. And also, he should be a person who has got a good insight, and a person that is so self-reliant. So these are some very, in a nutshell, I'm just explaining about the characteristics or about the conditions of a good mental health. Thank you.